Hey everyone, so I am back with another back to basics video. I've been wanting to continue this series. Like the first one was all about braids, which I'll link below. This time I want to do something where it's all about curls. And I had posted an Instagram photo of how I curled my hair, like for an event, which you can see below. And I had questions that, you know, of like how to actually curl your hair, and I thought it would be a perfect video to do everything about curling your hair in this video. So it's kind of like a mother of all videos for curling hair. So I'm gonna get started. I have four types of tools that I want to show you guys, but first I wanted to talk about the texture of my hair. I have a decent amount of hair that but it's just fine, and it's one of those where, you know, I can just let it air dry and it'll just be completely it'll just dry like this, like kind of straight, and I don't usually put anything in my hair. The only times I'll put something in my hair is that I want texture, because with the curls, a lot of times they'll fall out if I don't put something in my hair in order to have it stay throughout the whole day. Before I start with any type of like hair tools or anything that's heated for my hair, I want to start off with using any type of heat protectant spray for your hair. So this one here is a Tresemme Keratin Smooth that I don't typically use, but you know, it has keratin in it, which is, you know, something that I do look for, and it also protects your hair. So I like that it'll feed my hair with nutrients as well as protect it. It smells so good. So I'll spray it, and then I'll actually go over my hair once over with hairspray. And I'll go over that again after I curl my hair. I'm gonna actually section my hair off just so it's easier for you guys to see. First hair tool I am actually going to use is a flat iron. You can actually, I don't actually use the flat iron to flatten my hair because it's straight. So I use it to curl. And I find this to be the most lasting of all of the hair tools that I use. I mean, I'll just use it once and it stays pretty much the whole day, and it stays really curled. So this I use to if I really want a lot of curls, I would use this one. So what I do is I clamp down, and then I go around the barrel once, and then I twist. Then depending on how curly you want your hair to be, I just hold it for a little bit, then I slide down, hold it, slide down, hold it, slide down. And I do this to the length of the hair. So I'll kind of twist it a little bit too, and then just pull. And this one is the Qi flattening iron, which I've had for like so many years, and it still lasts really well. So you see, you can see this is the type of curl. I can go back up if I want to do additional one, and then I kind of just do like this, but I won't go all the way down. So that's that. So I'm gonna do another section just to show you again. The amount of curl to a strand also depends on like the thickness of your strand as well. So this is fairly thin, which will give you even tighter curls. Because it takes less time to actually heat up the strand, and then you'll really get that nice curl. So you see? So that is flat iron. Okay, so this side, I'm gonna show what I did for the event. And this I'm using, which is I believe it's a 1 inch or 1.5 inch barrel. And so in order to get a nice curl, you want to start here, you clamp down, and then once again you go towards the curve of the barrel, not the opposite, otherwise you'll have a kink. And then you wait a few seconds, then you start moving, kind of release a little bit, an inch, and then twist again. And then one more time. And you do this until you're done the length of your strand. So I kind of like just release a little bit and then curl. One more time. And then wait, and the reason why you do this is because when you start in the middle, you're actually not going to, you won't fry your ends that way. It makes it a healthier curl, but this is what that looks like. So I'll do another one. And you can alternate your direction of your curl. So since I had the barrel facing inward, this time I'm going to do it outwards. So because I have to look at the barrel itself, you want the clip to go, it's like direction of the curl. So since I curled this way, that curled inwards. Now I want it to curl this way, which curls outwards. But always follow the curve of your barrel. So because I want to curl this way, I clamp inwards and then I give it a twist backwards or outwards. And then same thing, I'm just going to just inch out of the strands and then just continue to grab it. Honestly, when I curl my hair, I have very, very little patience. So this is the right way to curl. And sometimes I just cheat and just curl wherever I can. And it usually takes me about like 10 minutes to do so. So this takes longer because I'm talking to you guys. I want to make sure that I don't forget anything. And if I do, it will be in the blog post, which I'll have a link below, which will give you a little bit more information if I didn't cover it in this video. So here's the other curl. Okay. Ooh, I'm gonna get like nice different types of curls in my hair. So I'm going to actually spray it because I want to show you guys them individually. So the next two tools I use are clipless iron, but they're two different types. One is this here, which is a Sea-Doo Revolution clipless iron. This one, I believe, is this has to be like a 3/4 inch or a 1 inch. This might be a 1 inch. I'm not sure, but I will double check and post it on my blog. But the way I use this, and you can use a glove to be safe, which I'll recommend, but I'm not using it right now. But what you want to do is I kind of face it downward. So, and this one here is just like a straight one size barrel, and I just wrap it around the barrel. And this one you kind of just hold, and you hold for like 30 seconds. Even less. It could be like 20 or 30 seconds. And that you get this type of curl. I find this lasting pretty long too. The only thing is that, you know, with a glove, you can actually curl the ends even nicer, but because I was holding it, it's not curled as nicely. So the glove does help with that, but I'm not very picky about my curls. So that's what that looks like. And then the next one is similar fashion, but it has a conical shape. So same thing, and I'll just point down and I'll just do this. So it has a conical shape where it is thick at the top, but then it goes really pointy towards the end of the strand. So I'll do it for like 15 seconds. This curl looks like. Okay? So I hope this video was helpful. I am going to post more information on my blog, so please check that out because I will add additional tips that I may not have covered in this video, and the link will be below. If there are any questions, feel free to leave a comment below, or you can tweet me at LaBelleMel31, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye!